What's up everyone and welcome back to my channel. Dom Designs here and today I will teach you how to draw this delicious coffee in Adobe Illustrator. Alright, so I dragged in a quick sketch I created into Illustrator and set it as a template. The document size I am using is a 1080 by 1080 pixels. As always, if you're new to the channel and interested in my style of illustrations in Adobe Illustrator, then please consider subscribing and hitting that bell notification so you don't miss my weekly uploads. Let's create a new layer and name it Outline. I will then select a black colored stroke with rounded caps and corners. Let's begin the outline with the ellipse tool. I will do a copy and paste in front of the oval and then make it smaller. Using the direct selection tool, I will move up the top anchor points creating this half circle effect. Now let's select the two shapes and bring up the shape builder. Just click and drag to combine the shapes and then click on the gray areas to create new shapes. Use the pen tool to create the left side of the glass. Then bring up the reflect tool and then Option or Alt click in the middle to mirror the lines we created. Since there is an anchor in the middle, let's delete it and then reconnect the lines using the pen tool. Now we will want to round off the bottom part, so for that I will bring up our rulers. You can do Command or Control R to do so. Then I will drag a guide in the middle of the illustration. Now that we have that guide, with the curvature tool I will click and drag on the line to curve it. Finally, with the direct selection tool we could curve in the corners. Perfect, so let's create the inside of the glass. Select the outer glass shape and go to the object menu at the top and select offset path. Play with the units until you get something like this. Now let's select all the lines and bring up the shape builder. Hold Option or Alt on your keyboard and carefully click to delete the lines intersecting like this. I will use the ellipse tool once more to create the bottom part of the glass. By holding Option or Alt on your keyboard, drag a copy directly below it. Delete the anchor point and reconnect the side with the pen tool. With the direct selection, select the anchors and move them up to create this 3D-like effect. For the stem, I will create the right side with a rectangle. Curve the side with the curvature tool, and then mirror it to the left. Combine the shapes using the Shape Builder tool just like we did earlier. Finally, I will use the width tool to make these taper off. Beautiful, we're almost done the outline. We just need to draw the handle. I will create two perfect circles holding Shift on my keyboard. I will use the Shape Builder tool to delete the unwanted lines to connect the handle. So we're done the outline, now let's add the base colors. For starters, I will create a new layer below the outline and name it Color. I will select everything on the outline layer and copy it down to the color layer. For this, I will hold Option or Alt on my keyboard and drag down the red square down to the color layer. Make sure to lock the outline layer after. Next, we will select the illustration on the color layer and outline the stroke. Then I will go to the Pathfinder panel and unite all the shapes. Next, right-click and ungroup, and then right-click again to release the clipping mask. Now just select everything and give it a color in order to see the drawing. So now we'll select every individual piece and give it a base color. Over here, you will notice that the circle in the middle of the handle should not be colored in. So I will select the handle in the circle shape and use a shape builder to make a hole. Make sure to remove the circle shape inside, and there seems to be another layer behind it, so just delete that one as well. Alright, so let's create the layers in the coffee. I will create 3 ovals. So what I will do here is delete the top anchor point and just connect the shapes with the pen tool. Then let's select the shapes and bring up the shape builder to delete the middle oval. Let's give this shape a white color, and then I will do the same for the next layer of coffee. Let's split the brown shape with a darker tone. Select the shape and do a Command C and then Command F twice to paste 2 shapes on top of each other. Move the top layer, creating this gap in the middle. And then delete the unwanted shape with the shape builder. When you're done, you can give this bottom shape a darker brown color. Let's give the middle of the glass some highlights. Select the darkest coffee color shape and do a copy and paste in front. Then bring the shape to the front and give it a white color. Next, I will bring down the opacity of the shape in order to see behind it. Let's create a duplicate and resize the shape inwards. Duplicate the shape again and resize the shape towards the middle. Now let's select all the shapes and with the Shape Builder tool delete the outermost shapes. Alright, so I will be repeating these steps with the Shape Builder tool to create the shadows and the highlights of the illustration. And there you have it, everyone. This is how I create a fancy cup of coffee in Adobe Illustrator. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, please let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Cheers, everyone.